Dear students, in continuation with the solution of a problem, today we will go for second part of it, that is solution by using nominal pi representation, that is B part. So this is pi representation of given network. IC1 and IC2 are the two currents through half of the line capacitance. IR is receiving end current, IS is sending end current, VS is sending end voltage, and VR is receiving end voltage. R plus JXL is line impedance. Taking receiving end voltage as a reference, we get IC1 equal to Y/2 into VR, that is equal to J3 into 10 to the power minus 4 by 2 into (76.21 kV). This 76.21 kV we are taking from part A calculations. When simplified, we get it as 11.43 amperes. Now we need to calculate line current IL. IL is equal to IC1 plus IR. IR we will take from, again, part A solution. IL equal to IC1 plus IR. That is 273.21 0.36 into the bracket 0.8 minus j0.6 plus j11.43, that is equal to, adding these two using calculator, you will get 218.688 minus j152.586. amperes. We can convert this into polar form, that will become 266.65 at an angle of minus 34.90 degrees. Make use of your calculator, rectangular to polar conversion button, right? Next, we need to calculate VS, that is sending end voltage. Voltage across the sending end, voltage across the sending end is equal to voltage across capacitor 2, and that is equal to voltage across Z, this you can call as impedance Z, plus voltage across capacitor C1. Because these two impedances are connected in parallel with capacitor C2. So you know that when circuit components are connected in parallel, voltage across them will be equal. But voltage across capacitor C1 is what? Receiving end voltage. So you can write VR plus ILZ, that is equal to 76.21, you don't show any angle because it is our reference voltage, plus IL, that is 266.65 at an angle of minus 34.90 degree, into Z. Z is known to us, that is 10 plus J30 into 10 raised to minus 3. That comes out to be 82.97 plus J5.034 kV. Or in polar form, -83.13 at an angle of 3.472 degree kV. Now we can calculate sending end line voltage, because this is phase voltage as we consider per phase equivalent circuit. Sending end line voltage is equal to 83.12 into root 3, now we can calculate current through capacitor C2, that is IC2, as Y by 2 into VS, where VS is per phase sending end voltage, that is J 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 2 into 82.97 plus J5.034 into 10 raised to 3. On simplification, we get it as 0.755 plus J12.446 amperes. Once we calculate IC2 by making use of KCL at sending end junction, we can calculate sending end current IS. IS is equal to IC2 plus IL. That would be equal to 0.755 plus J12.446 plus 218.688 minus J152.586 ampere. That is equal to 260.37 at an angle of minus 32.56 degrees ampere in polar form. Now you can calculate power factor because we know the phase angle of sending end voltage and sending end current. Now you can calculate sending end power factor. Sending end power factor is equal to cos of phase angle of sending end voltage minus phase angle of sending end current. The phase angle of sending end voltage is equal to 3.472 degrees minus of minus 32.56 degrees. This is nothing but cos phi s, that means sending end power factor. And this will be equal to 0.809 lagging. To calculate regulation, we need to calculate receiving end voltage at no load, that is V dash, and V dash is nothing but, here you have to take just magnitude for regulation calculation. Looking at the pi network, you can understand how to calculate no load receiving end voltage. When there is no current flowing through this, these two terminals will not be having any meaning for us, electrically speaking. Therefore, voltage across this capacitor will become voltage across a receiving end. That means IL and IC1 will be equal. So to calculate what is voltage across IC1, we can make use of voltage divider rule. That is, total voltage across this series branch into the capacitive impedance divided by total impedance of series branch. And that will be equal to Vs into Y by 2 raised to minus 1. Raised to minus 1 because we need impedance here given is admittance. Reciprocal of admittance is impedance. So it is inverse. Inverse means you are taking reciprocal. Similarly here also, the sum of impedances connected in series. That will be equal to 83.13 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 2 raised to minus 1 divided by 10 plus j 30 plus j 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 by 2 raised to minus 1 magnitude. That will be equal to 83.51 kV. Therefore, percentage regulation is equal to 100, which comes out to be 83.51 minus 76.21 divided by 76.21 into 100. That is equal to 83.51 minus 76.21 divided by 76.21 into 100. That is equal to, that will be approximately equal to 9.58%. Next, we have to calculate line efficiency. Line efficiency neta is equal to, so it is percentage efficiency only, receiving end power divided by receiving end power plus 3 times line losses, because we are considering here per phase diagram, 3 IL square into R. That is equal to 50 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 50 into 10 raised to 6 plus 3 into IL square, that is 266.65 whole square into 10 into 100, because we need to calculate percentage efficiency. Therefore, we get, on simplification, the efficiency as 95.91%. So this is complete solution of the problem that we took in last class. Dear students, I will stop this class here and continue in next class with long transmission line performance analysis. Thank you.